Yeah, this is fine. Yeah. So I think, this is, I am representing SEPT University, and I would be talking about the courses which are there for the, you know, after 12th, you know, which is mostly the inquisitiveness which the students have at this point in time after they receive their 12th results. So I'll just start the presentation. I'll share my screen with you all. Is it visible?
Yes, visible, ma'am. It's visible.
Okay. Yeah. Fine. So, you know, talking about the university, and I don't know where to put this Zoom meeting. So I'll talk about the university, the philosophy which the university believes in, and the programs which we have, and broadly what the campus life is at the SEPT University. Now, to initiate, our university is the first university in India which is a habitat university. And why do we say we are habitat university? Because we have all courses related to the built environment which exists in the country. So, you know, we have been creating professionals which are talking about planning the cities, designing the houses, the buildings, the further product designs or the furniture designs which come within the building, and so forth. So it starts from a very larger scale to something which is within the built form, but it partakes all the parameters which are involved in the built form. So we are a habitat university in that sense. And we also talk about the management part of it, lastly, to add on. So how does the services part run and all of those things? So we are existing since 1962. And we have these many domains, as I mentioned in the previous slide also: architecture, design, planning, technology, and management. So now, talking about the scopes which possibly you have, if at all you are in this domain of the habitat anywhere. So looking at the recent trends, we are identified as the world's fastest growing economy. Now, this is the recent figure published in 2019 by IMF. Further, again, United Nations with the Sustainable Development Goals is saying that between 2000 and 2014, the cities have grew 1.28 times faster than the population rise within them. So urban areas are increasing at a very faster pace. And if we talk about the possible scopes for habitat professionals, the Royal Institute of Chartered Surveyors, which is a well-known institute, it has identified that we have a gap of 80 to 83% of professionals in this domain. Now, SEPT University, if I talk about the pedagogy which we have at, we give them studio-based learning, wherein the students engage themselves in their lifelike real situations, problem solving. And that gives them a basic exposure to what are the real problems in and around us. And they try to find out solutions for those real problems. So over here, you can see the students are creating something with bamboo. They are creating the surface structures, over here, using the softwares and the workshop facilities on our campus. And they are trying to, after the prototype, they are also trying to create or build on site, on campus itself. So over here, the role of the teachers is more so guiding them and supporting them. The students have to take a lot of initiative, and they have to crack their heads to find out solutions, discuss with the teachers which are more like mentors, and many a times many of them are professionals who are working in the field. So that's the unique point which SEPT University carries. So it's also collaborating with teachers and professionals both. It's a great opportunity while you are a student at SEPT. Further to this, we have a student to teacher ratio, which is for every 10 to 12 students, there is one teacher. So I think that one of the finest ratios which we have, and the student is almost getting a personal attention while he or she is studying through the course of the undergraduate program at the university. So, And besides, we have the choice-based curriculum, wherein if you are studying, for example, in Faculty of Architecture, you can as well take the elective in Faculty of Planning or Management. So it is across the university. So if you want something in design, so you, while you are studying in architecture, you can go to Faculty of Design and study their elective. So it gives you good exposure overall. Further, we nurture the culture on our campus. This is way back, a long time back when the color photographs were not yet in. So, the students and the leadership initiatives, the participating decision making of the university. So that culture we still nurture, and it's a very good learning. It's not only being student at SEPT and learning about knowing more about the academics and all of those things, but it is also the holistic development of a personality as a human being. So I think all of these things make a lot of difference if you are a student at SEPT. So talking about the various programs, so we have 5 undergraduate programs and 17 postgraduate programs. So we are not a huge university. So roughly around 1,500 to 2,000 students. And this is the organization of the university. This is, I think, I put over here to show you the 9 centers which we have towards the extreme right end, CRDF. So these 9 centers are very good R&D centers. Also, you get some opportunity to work and learn wherein actual projects are going on. I'll be talking a bit later about those things. So now talking about the bachelor's programs. So BR, BCT, BID, Bachelor of Design and Urban Design. These are the undergraduate programs at SEPT. And same way for postgraduate, I'll not be talking about the PG programs much over here in this forum. So yeah, as I said, I'll be elaborating about the centers a bit later. Just to name a few out of 9-10 centers. Center of Excellence in Urban Transport. So you can see the BRTS corridor. So Ahmedabad BRTS corridor has been done by SEPT. Hubli Dharwad BRTS corridor is being looked at by SEPT. So many other places we have been involved in that through Center of Excellence in Urban Transport. A lot of work has been done by Center of Excellence in Urban Equity, wherein slum dwellers and their occupation and all of those things, talking about the urban equity and all. So another is this CWAS, Water and Sanitation Center. We have been involved with the government in looking at 400 urban local bodies in Gujarat, Maharashtra, MP and Rajasthan. And we have done a lot of field-based work and what are the service levels which are being provided by the urban local bodies, what are the innovative solutions which could be adopted by the urban local bodies. So a lot of R&D work has been done in water and sanitation. And the last one I would like to mention is the CABS Center, which is the energy center in the built environment. And this building, which is the net zero energy building, which we have on campus itself. So whatever energy which has been consumed by the building, equal amount of energy is being produced by this building. So we have CARB Center, that's Center for Advanced Research in Building Science and Energy. And the building energy program, that is a master's program, is also available over here. So now I was mentioning the possibility of working in all of these types of centers while you are a student, or there might also be student assistantship which might be available over there. Okay, so this is part of academics, students, juries, and student festivals. This is the installation by the students during the Navratri. Again, this is the final jury and the exhibition put up by the students. The lab sessions, the electives, so this is all about life at SEPT. This is the SEPT workshop. And it's along with the academics, which the students enjoy. They also enjoy life at SEPT, which is student-led activity. So this is the night which the student has organized. This is the Engineers Day celebration by Faculty of Technology. This is the installation done by them, the students. Talking about the other exposures, which is Summer Winter School, which happened at SEPT. So until now, total 667 courses have been offered, and we have 58 courses which have happened outside India, across the world. This is also part of the Summer Winter School installation, which has been there. So these are the various locations where Summer Winter Schools have happened. They may be on campus, they might be outside campus also, across India, and these are across the world. So I mentioned 58 have done across the world. So, and formal collaborations with the universities across the world. We have 26 universities in Europe, Asia, Australia, and North America. So students come in exchange, wherein our students go there and their students come to our university for one semester, and they earn the credits from there. So these are the few students who have come for exchange at SEPT. So these are the few universities which we have partnered with. So besides that, this is just for you to get a brief idea about the culture at SEPT. So we get students from across the country. So these are the round dots which you see. Mostly 35% from Gujarat, and rest of the people from across India. So it's cosmopolitan culture over here, and I would say, along with it, as you've seen, that there's a lot of work with the students do on campus. You must have seen the exhibition output from the students and all in my previous slides. So they need to be on campus. So it's like their second home. So when it's second home, they also have their leisure time. They hardly, make less visits to their home. So parents wonder many a times, why are they not coming home and all. But there's a lot of work that they need to do. And I would like to specially mention over here for 12th graders that entering in college does not mean that enjoyment wala phase shuru hua. There's a lot of hard work that you need to do when you enter into these professional courses. It's not an easy maneuvering through the college life. Yeah. So finally, after all this hard work, I would just like to it's a happy graduation day for many of the students. And there's one good news which I would like to share at this point. Just last week, Government of India has released the national ranking, NIRF ranking. So in that ranking, SEPT University is fourth rank across India, in the architecture domain. So you can also go to the website, NIRF website, MHRD, and you can just go through where SEPT stands. So these are the facilities at SEPT. This is the structural lab. This is the workshop which we have, wood workshop, the one of the finest in India. So this is the library facilities at SEPT. We have the student services. If you face any difficulties on campus, there is IT, alumni office, student services. So wherein the student can easily approach them. It is very friendly environment. It's not a very formal where you might need, the student needs to think twice or before approaching anyone. So again, no, it's a private university. So we do have fees, but we also take care that always the meritorious students get the benefit and they don't need to leave out. So a lot of scholarships are there. 15% of the students entering in any program do get scholarships. They are merit-based, mean-based at the time of taking admission. And after that also, there are many special scholarships which are available. There is teaching assistantship which is available. So if you're a student in, let's say, fourth year, you can assist this teacher in the first year. And as you are studying, you can earn. Okay. So student assistantship is also there. No, suppose campus office requires some work, data log maintained karna, and if they need some help. So they recruit students and to help them. So the students are paid for these kind of assistantships. So it's earned while you learn. It's something that exists. So that's also an opportunity for the students to help with the financial burden which they might be facing. Not all, but quite a few of it. Now, if you want to know what kind of work is being done at SEPT, you can visit SEPT portfolio and you should be able to see what all things go on campus. What kind of studio projects are students doing? So that's something which is on our website. The other is the Facebook page. The recent announcements that happen keep on happening on our Facebook page. One of the best things that you should not miss if you are interested in this domain is the exhibitions which we have. We have summer exhibition and we have the winter exhibitions. So every semester end, it's a display of all the work which has been done by the undergraduate students, by the postgraduate students. The entire campus is open for people to come on the campus and see what kind of work do the students do. So I think everybody is welcome. It happens in May and December. Okay, so you can keep looking at the Facebook page and look at the announcement dates for the exhibitions. Now coming to about the seat distribution and the admissions part. We have SEPT All India seats, which is 50% of the total sanctioned seats, and SEPT ACPC seats, which is the government seats, out of the total intake. So in SEPT ACPC seats also, again, the distribution is the 90% of the seats are for the Gujarat board and 10% of the seats are for other boards which are located in Gujarat. That is Gujarat-based CBSE, ICSE, and other boards, IB and all. So talking about the seats available in different courses. So BYARC, we have 80 intakes. So 40 seats are All India seats and 40 seats are government ACPC seats. So students from Gujarat can apply in both. But for All India seats, you need to make a separate application. Okay. And for ACPC seats also, you need to make a separate application. So mostly all the applications are available on our website. So the announcement of the admission will also be done. We have not yet done any announcement for admissions this year. But very soon we'll be doing that in July or so. Once the announcement is done, the entire process is going to be online. BCT, same way, we have 30-30. Interior design, it's 30-30. B design, the seats may revise this year. So earlier it was 20 seats. It might be updated this year. And lastly, it is urban design, bachelor's in urban design. That's only All India seats. B design and urban design, we have only All India seats. There's no ACPC seats in that. So this I've already mentioned in my previous slide. You need to apply separately for both the seats if you are from Gujarat. And you need to just observe that SEPT seats, it's completely on, admission offer is completely on the merit based. Okay. So across all boards, a common merit is prepared. You might be seeing the ACPC seats, you have seats distribution as per the boards, which is not so in SEP seats. Okay. So I think this is the brief information I have. I would just like to mention one point. BRQ need to clear NATA, and the merit list is prepared on the basis of 50% weightage of the NATA score and 50% weightage of the 12th marks score. For BCT and BID, this time SEPT has applied to the government, and we have said that for BCT, we should be allowed to use the JEE score, and for BID, we should be allowed to use the NATA score. But unless we get a nod from the government for this change, this is something which we will not be able to announce it formally. So if it is not allowed, if it is not okayed by the government for this cycle, then we would be having our own entrance test, which used to be earlier also. For BCT and BID, we used to have our own entrance test. So if at all we have our own entrance test, the announcement will be made on the website. For B design program, which is building products and systems, no? This is the program wherein we will be taking the UCED scores, 50% of the scores from UCED entrance exam. As for NATA, we have NATA, that is a national level test. UCED is also a national level test for any course in design. Okay, so UCED 50% marks and 12th 50% marks. So that is the way by which the merit will be prepared for the B design program. For urban design also, mostly it will be NATA, but the announcements will be made on our website. Okay, so you need to keep checking our website. I think any other information from the admissions perspective is required from the participants end. I don't know whether question answers are allowed or not. I'll rather get back to Malay Bhai. Yeah.
Yes. Abhishek, please take it forward. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for detailed information about all the SEPT culture, facilities, and courses, and all the details. We have some questions from the viewers. One of the questions we have from the FB viewer, that SEPT is a UGC approved or AICTE approved, and does it affect on the career?
It is UGC approved. We have mentioned on our website also, and I don't think so. I mean, it's there since 1962, and we have professionals which are well known professionals. Bimal Patel is also a SEPT alumni. And I think Rahul Mehrotra is also SEPT alumni. So I think well-known architects or urban planners are there who are SEPT alumni. So I think this question is a worry from their end. They can look at the website, UGC approved, and all those things are mentioned on the admissions website.
Okay. And one more question we have got.
I would just like to mention the possible reason. Earlier, SEPT was a government-funded university, which we have stopped taking the grants from the government, and now it's a private university. That's the only difference which is there.
Okay. So might be that due to that reason, person has asked the question. Another one more question is there. How much placement does SEPT provide in the furniture design segment? Is a typical question about some particular section?
Yeah.
Which someone has asked.
Furniture design, we have, this is, I think, undergraduate level question, not a PG. PG, we have specific master's course in furniture design, especially. Undergraduate course is bachelor's in design. But focus is, it's not any product design, which otherwise design schools have that course. For SEPT, it is not like a general product design course. The design course is focused or oriented towards the products related to buildings and furniture. So since we are a Habitat University, we focus on the built form majorly. So it is not any other product design which we are looking at, but it's specifically building products and furniture. So that is the inclination which the program will have. That and that information is there for the students to know. फिर वो ये सोच के आएंगे कि ये products जैसे दूसरे design schools में product design करवाते हैं वैसा ही हम नहीं करवाते हैं. No, our program is not oriented like that. So it's not a specialization, it's just for information. Program is B-Design. So there, I would just like to share, ये 20 seats थी पहले, अभी ये 40 seats हो रही है. So there is huge demand for that, and students are getting opportunities outside, be it entrepreneurial opportunity or working with the other agencies. So we are increasing the number of seats for B-Design program.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am. Another question we have that, can you just give a detailed insight about how to crack the SPIPA entrance and how GATE and from GATE and GRE the person can take admission in the SEP, and what is the process? Or
no, I am not getting this question correctly. GATE is something which you need to appear after your engineering. I mean GRE is if you aim to go out of country to study after your graduation and all. So, I mean, for SEP entrance, I'm not getting this question very clearly.
Okay. Just one person has asked that by giving this entrance exam, is it possible to get into the SEP, or is there any admission?
I have mentioned the types of entrance tests that are required. For architecture, you need to appear for national level, national architecture test in National Aptitude Test in Architecture, that is NATA. Okay. For BCT, we have asked the government to allow JEE scores. So 50% scores for JEE entrance and mains, and 50% for 12th. Same way as we have for NATA. Same we have asked from the government to do for BCT, but on JEE basis. So if we get a nod from them, we'll do that way. This cycle itself. If you don't get a nod from them, SEP has its own entrance test for which you need to apply, and the dates will be informed. Ki ye date ko entrance test hogi, and you need to appear for that. Okay. And weightages, bifurcation, everything will be announced on the website. For example, pehle jab tha test hamara last year, so 60% weightage for BCT was there for our entrance test, and 40% for 12th marks. Okay, that was the weighted distribution. So all these informations will be announced on the website.
Okay. Yeah. And with this current pandemic situation, which is ongoing, what is your view on the new career avenues and we see in the designing and in the designing point of view in SEP and in future? In the current scenario of pandemic situation.
I mean, this more so is a question which largely applies to the final year students who are already going to graduate in the near future. And, okay, so for new students, I would like to say, those who want to join the course, any of our entrance tests, if we announce, the entire process will be online. So they should be able to appear for any kind of a test sitting at their home. They don't need to come to campus, which earlier they used to come to campus, they used to appear for the test and they used to go back. So whatever mode we adopt, it will be completely online this time.
Okay. Another question we have from Jasmita Itesh. Do BR program is well enough singly, or is better with MR, Master in Architecture?
I think you should at least study BR thoroughly. Masters is a specialization which you might realize whether you want to go for further studies as you do your graduation or not. I mean, it's something which depends on person's individual's inclination also. So
okay. And
Is she a student who wants to pursue post-graduation, or is she a student who wants to pursue undergraduate studies? I'm not getting. If she's a person who wants to pursue PG, then I would answer rather her in a better way.
Seeing the question, what we can understand that she's a student and she's thinking that doing BR, but is it okay with BR, or she should learn a master's also along with that, or BR is sufficient? A question is that
it's a tricky question, because it's completely on an individual. No, if you feel that you work for some years and you feel that I need to further study, you may go for a master's. Otherwise, you may not, because it's a profession. See, all these courses at SEP, They are undergraduate professional courses after which you can start working as an individual on your own, or you may have your own office, or you may join with somebody's or work in some other industry and all, where architects are required. So master's is something, I mean, which you may do if you want.
Okay.
Depending okay. on, yeah.
Okay, one more last question. Actually, whoever want to get admission SAP always have a worry that what is the placement ratio and what is the average CTC for the students. Last question you got. What is the placement ratio for the SAP students and what is the average CTC for the students?
For the placement part, I would say no. Except in this domain, as I mentioned, the NIRF ranking part. So mostly our students get placed. Either they work with others or they may establish their own setup. You know, they are entrepreneurs by themselves. So we had only intake of 40 for many years. This 80 number of intake is only since 2-3 years. So as such, we have never ever faced this issue, because being on top, it's not only in India, but in Asia, I would say it's one of the finest universities in this domain. So our students have never faced these issues. So either they are in the entrepreneurial mode or they work with agencies. So there are our students who are working in these larger firms in Bangalore, HCP itself in Ahmedabad. So I don't think it's a problem. So for this, suggest that very soon we would be rolling out the student ambassadors. Like for postgraduate programs, it's already book page. So there are program ambassadors. So if at all you want to pose any questions about, you know, how do you study, what is the environment, how do you work after your graduation, all of these studies, you can also, I mean, mostly students are keen ki bhai abhi existing students ke saath hume baat karni hai. So we have rolled out this student ambassador program. So very soon they will also be placed. Once we announce our undergraduate admissions, we will be announcing the ambassadors also for various programs. BR ke liye bhi honge, BCT ke liye bhi honge. So they can talk to our students to get a better level of satisfaction. And had it been any kind of fear, you know, university ko agar fear hai ki bhai ye kya batayenge students, then we would never ever roll out such initiative in the public domain, जहाँ पे बाहर से कोई भी आके हमारे students को पूछ सकता है. So I think
SAP itself is a name, actually people know very well that what is SAP and how it works and everything. So that is not a concern.
So they should be better to talking to their program ambassadors, which are our own students. So they can have that interaction. This time, especially, we are making this effort because everything is online. Otherwise, they can come to campus, they can talk to people, even student interaction we keep in our open house. So it's possible for them to talk about all of these questions to our students themselves. And we call all from second year to first year, second year to final year. Sare students ko hum bulate hain. So I think this ambassador program will be helpful to the students who want to join SEPT. Yeah, they can talk to our ambassadors.
Okay, ma'am. That's all. Actually, the questions were there. And thank you very much that you have given all the detail about the SAP admission process, what are the entrance, and how the student can get. And that is a very useful that student ambassador program is there, which will help the students also to get the information about the same. So that is also a good thing. And thank you very much for time. And you have just given a detailed information about everything, how SAP works and what are the things, how students get the exposure.
Yeah.
Thank you, ma'am.